Hi, I'm Andy, and I'm back again to show you how a CL console or a QL console can do wireless microphone monitoring and control. We need a Shure ULX-D, either 4D or 4Q models, because these devices use Dante, the same audio networking as the consoles and the R-Series I.O. racks. So put all the devices into the same Dante network. Then there's a little bit of setup to do. Let me show you. First, on the ULX-D, we enter the menu and we go to Device Utilities. Open that and find Network. In the network, we have the configuration setting. We can go there and we need to choose either switched mode or redundant audio. They're the two modes that are going to work for us. Then in the Dante setting, open that one, we need to set the device ID. And there's several modes for the ID. We need, of course, Yamaha mode. So choose that and then choose a unique ID number for each ULX-D device that you have. Then enter that, then just wait a moment while that saves. And then in the audio and control setting, we can make sure it's using automatic mode for the IP address. That's the default setting, and that's the setting that is going to work the easiest for us. So that's all done, we can exit from there. And now we come to the mixer. We need to enter the setup menu and go to Dante Setup, then Device Mount, and we're going to mount the wireless microphones. So choose a blank setting here, and then go to the online device list, and we should find in this list the Shure ULX-D. Press OK, and then that device will be mounted. There it is. Now we can find it in the I/O device menu, and the wireless tab here. There it is, ULX-D. Look, if I press there, it flashes the front panel to identify it. And you can see all the channels here, and it says controllable. Let's open this up, and what do we see? We can have a device name, so each microphone can be named. Then we see the frequency it is operating at. Then we have a gain control. We can adjust that with the encoders here. So increase my microphone level like that, or decrease it back down again. Then there's a mute, and then RF level and battery status monitoring there. Very, very useful. Now, when we patch the microphones to the channels, then we can see the details in the channel views as well. So let's do that. Go to the Dante patch menu, Dante input patch, then channel 1 is going to be the first ULX-D, and channel 2 is going to be, yes, the second ULX-D. Let's do that. Now take a look at a channel view. So here in the channel strips we can see the status of the microphones, and then in the selected channel we can see it there as well. Open that and there it is. Now, up to 24 ULX-D devices can be monitored and controlled at the same time, and both front of house and monitor consoles can simultaneously have that control. So I'm sure you'll agree it's a very useful feature as part of version 4. Be sure to check out the other videos where we describe all the additional features for CL and QL version 4. Thanks for your time.